Okay guys, so we have a really awesome assembly plan for us today. Let's quiet down guys. Okay, we got a really fun assembly plan for us today by the class of 99. It's gonna be really awesome. So, now could you all please stand and repeat the pledge after me?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh shit, it's
fine. All right, and now we're going to have the national anthem by Craig Wignall. We welcome the class of 1999. If you have ever heard the phrase, party like it's 1999, then you'll understand why it is such a big deal that these alumni are here today. They survived Y2K. The entire world was preparing for the millennial bug to shut down computer systems worldwide. It was expected that all computer-based technology entities like banks, schools, water treatment plants, and the stock market were going to stop working as the year 2000 rolled in. As the clock hit midnight and they welcomed in the year 2000, it all turned out okay. They also survived all the 90s fashions. The one true tragedy of their senior year was the Columbine High School massacre. That day will never be forgotten. It was an event in their lives that changed everything. These alumni are also haunted by the scary movies that they watched 20 years ago. The Sixth Sense and Toy Story 2 still give them nightmares. 20 years ago, Spanish Fork was mostly fields. They didn't have any clothing stores in town. The cool restaurants to hang out during lunch were Hoagie Yogi and Glades. Or they lined up at Macy's deli counter to get one piece of lunch meat, one piece of cheese, and one bagel. This is the class that invented the bagel sandwich. These guys only had to pay $1.22 for a gallon of gas. They were the first generation to have a Game Boy in color. They were also the first generation to have widespread use of email. They got their first Hotmail and Gmail accounts during their senior year. However, most of them still had to type their college applications on typewriters because most families didn't have home computers yet. Nobody had cell phones, but a few of the cool kids had pagers. The only texting ability they had was to send the numbers 143 to someone's pagers. That meant I love you. This is the year...
143 Taylor Gordon!
All right. This is the year that MySpace and Bluetooth were announced, but they were not used yet. This class just cruised Ming to meet up with each other and hang out. The alumni of 1999 are here and ready to put on a fun assembly and announce the homecoming royalty for 2018. I will now turn the time over to Julie Euler Harris, the senior class president of 1999.
Having flashbacks of when we were out there looking up at these guys, and they look pretty dang old. And now, what the heck? It's our turn. So, those were the days though. We've had a lot of fun with everyone. We would cruise main, get in fights, get people chasing us, go find boys on main, try and find out-of-towners. Come show off to our boys and make them jealous. We had a lot of fun, but thank you for coming to your homecoming assembly. We hope you've had a fun week. We hope you have a fun day today and a good game tomorrow or tonight and a fun dance tomorrow. So I will turn the time over to our MCs.
Let me introduce my co-host here, tell you a little bit about her. 1999 Women's Volleyball Region MVP. All state, outside hitter right here. Volleyball. She once rescued 73 puppies from a burning building. This girl right here. 73, we counted, each one. Crazy. Pretty sure she's probably won a Nobel Peace Prize. She probably knows how to stop global warming. And 1999's best hair, maybe, was it?
No.
Okay, either way, she should have. Kim Mexican. No, for real, that's her last name, it's Mexican. Not kidding.
Guys, I'm super excited to introduce my co-host. So he, wait, this card's empty. Is that a mistake or? Oh.
Cheerleaders up here. Cheerleaders.
My good friend Jimmy Miller, by the way.
Video, show you guys a little bit about what you guys knew about 1999, which I'll be honest, is a little embarrassing, but that's okay.
Class of 1999.
Wow.
You know what this is?
No.
Go on and hold it for me. So you probably had like your music you were just listening to on your phone.
Oh, yeah. This is CD.
Yeah. Huh. We used to tilt those around, and if that went missing, they were like $1,000.
We used to get these. Have you guys ever heard
Blockbuster?
Of Blockbuster, right? That Blockbuster was our favorite place to go on the weekend to go rent one of these movies.
There's one near you. Blockbuster
Video. Fill it up quick. Drink this one instead.
All right.
It is soda. It's from the 1990s era.
It tastes like ginger cola.
Ginger cola.
What is it?
It's Sprite.
Nope.
And my name is Julie from the class of 1999, and you guys graduated 2021. We have a caboodle here. Do you guys know what a caboodle is? Makeup, yes, it's for makeup and all other hair stuff. We used to carry these with us wherever we went.
It's 1999, don't be weird now.
What do I do?
It's a laser pointer. Give it a shot.
I'm not dressing up.
Try it on my shirt now. Check that out. This kid likes it.
Oh my gosh, that's so awesome.
All right, enough. This is what we did in the 90s. We drew on each other's shirt and text messaged each other from across the hall. Yeah, nice try. Give it back. Can through his hair, girl.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, thank you.
What's on this side?
It's
a pin. Get out of class.
It's a card reader or something. It's an old thing that I don't understand.
It's actually an apparatus used to text message back in 1999.
Oh, yeah. That's cool.
It is pretty cool.
And Bell? Nobody? Nobody? Nobody, Shepard.
I'm
thinking
of
Miss Swimming in summertime.
Is it a teacher?
Okay, that's the start. Are we going to do 20 questions?
Is it Ben?
Yes, and I think
how
it's
about
Gilbert.
Oh!
So we're going to do some trivia. Everyone get out your phones. And enter the back sets phone that we'll show you right up here. Y'all are about to get titty smashed. All right, enter the access code. No. You can join the game.
Oh my gosh, she kept throwing
or saving all your files to a floppy disk. There may be more than one right answer.
Question two, what movie from 1999 is still fun to watch today? 10 Things I Hate About You, Tarzan, Inspector Gadget, or Toy Story 2? Your hacky sack skills.
We have our hacky sack players come to the stage for you. Josie, Andrew, Georgie, we've got some volunteers for the class of 1999. We're going to see who can get the most consistent in 1 minute.
The winner, class of 99! Genius Panther, first place.
Who are you playing for the homecoming game?
In 1999, hair parted in the middle, gold jewelry, wedge sandals, or pants that flare to the bottom. By the way, you guys are welcome for this song. You should get credit for it. Alright, we're gonna do a fashion show for you.
What popular 1990 styles have made a comeback? They're gonna do the dogs, stretchies, or overalls. Stretchies!
too, and she still wears it today, so that's mean, but okay.
Thank you, models. You're awesome. Okay, next question.
All right, what famous quote hailed from our senior year? I see spirit people. Is that your last answer? Is that your final answer? Or I got a friend in you.
Close!
Boys, what about you? Hey, perfect, they're singing it for you. I want it that way. That's what Tyler says. You're welcome. Let's go, girls, come on. I'm going out tonight. I'm feeling all right. Gonna let it all hang out. Easy. This was his jam. Lou Dan, ghetto superstar. Come on, Tony.
They don't know what to play for them.
Let's just play it for them.
like, I'm not coming down until this is done.
Octopus.
Epic Octopus right here. It's the winner. I think she came to support the mom today.
All right. Now we have a few special speakers for you. We have all the varsity football players come up on stage.
Hey guys, while you're coming up, we have a few motivational speakers to help get you pumped up for your game tonight. First, we have the most spirited Don to ever grace these halls. And he has the title in the yearbook to prove it. Tony Johns!
Our next speaker is probably the best dressed guy up here. First guy I ever saw shave his legs, to be honest. And one of the best receivers in Don's history, Nate Dart.
And the next guy, in addition to returning not one, but two interceptions for a touchdown against Springville. In his spare time, he enjoys long walks on the beach and is an accomplished fiddle player, self-taught. Jared Harrison.
So Don's. Hey, listen up, Don's! Hey!
Hey, Arsenal!
I hear we got a tough one today against the Skyhawks, right? They're a tough team. We're tougher. Alright, so when you get out there, you're gonna go inside, you're gonna go outside. Inside and outside. When you get them on the run, you're gonna keep them on the run. And you're gonna go, 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 until you get across that goal line. When you get out there, when the Dons get there, they fight! Fight, 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 fight! Right, Don? Yeah.
Okay, Tony, I was afraid this might happen.
What?
Did you steal that from a movie?
Yeah.
I think you might have stole that from a movie.
It's a great movie.
Yeah, well, these kids are, they're the class of 2019, not
1929.
Yeah. So
okay.
I've got some other motivational speakers that we want to bring out.
Fine.
Now, Harry, come on. Let's see if Harry, if you can get these guys motivated to beat the Skyhawks. Let's see if Harry can do any better.
All right. Hey guys. I don't really know what to say. You know, 8 hours from now, it's the biggest football game of your life. It all comes down to tonight. Inch by inch, play by play, until you're finished. Dons, believe me, you guys are in a hole right now against those Skyhawks. Now, you can stay in that hole and get the crap kicked out of you, or you can fight your way back into the light. You can climb out of that hole one inch at a time. I'll tell you what though, the class of 99, those guys back there, those ladies back there, we can't do it for you. You know, I know why? We're too old. I look around and I see all these young faces. I mean, you find out in life that life is just a game of inches. So too, fellas, is football. Because in either game, life, or football, the margin for error is so small. I mean, one half step too late or too early, and you don't quite get it. One half second too slow or too fast, and you don't quite catch it. The inches you need are everywhere around you. In every break of the game, in every minute, in every second. Now listen up. As a Spanish Fork Don, you fight for that inch. As a Spanish Fork Don, you tear yourself and everyone around you to pieces for that inch. You claw with your fingernails for that inch. Because when you know, when you add up all those inches, that's going to be the difference, my partner. That's going to be the difference between winning and losing. Between living and dying. I'll tell you this much though. In any fight, it's the guy who's willing to die who's going to win that inch. Again, I tell you guys, we, the class of 99, we can't make you guys do it. We're not going to make you guys do it. You got to look at the guy next to you. You got to look at your teammates. Look them in the eyes, and I think you're going to see a guy that will go that inch with you. I think you're going to see a guy who will sacrifice himself for the team because he knows that when it comes down to it, you're going to do the same thing for him. That's a team, man. That's life. That's all it is. Now what are you going to do, boys?
My best friend for a long time, Harry.
Yep.
And now everybody in this room knows why, right? That was inspirational. But we need these guys getting pumped up.
Are you guys not pumped?
That was inspirational, but they're not pumped up. So I took it a step further.
Hold on.
They set me back a few bucks. But I hired a real motivational speaker.
Well, no, dude. Yes. Why?
Yes, I flew him in.
Whoa.
Got him here. Yeah, he's been in the back drinking Red Bulls and Monsters. Matt, are you ready? Matt, why don't you come on? Hey, Parker, Dallas, Sierra, why don't you guys join us on stage as well? Dallas and Parker.
Hey, how's everybody doing? All right. Now, as Mr. Dart just told you, my name is Matt Foley, okay? And I am a motivational speaker. I'd like to get started by letting you know a little bit about me and where I come from, okay? Okay. First off, I am 37 years old. I am thrice divorced. And I live in a van down by Salem Canal. You kids are probably asking yourself, I'm gonna go out there and grab the Skyhawks, I'm gonna pull them out and put them in my pocket, right? Right? Yeah. Well, I'm here to tell you that what you're probably gonna find, that you're not gonna amount to jack squat. You're gonna end up eating a steady diet of government cheese, working at Glades on the swing shift, and living in a van down by Salem Canal. Parker? Well, what do you want to do with your life, young man?
I want to play in the NFL.
Lottie frickin' dog! Joseph Montana? Who is that? I can't tell.
Parker, he's actually really good. He's got a really good arm.
I wish you'd shut your yappers. Dallas. Now what do you want to do with your life, young man?
I want to live in a van down by San Fernando.
Well, you're going to have plenty of time to live in a van down by San Fernando when you're living in a van down by San Fernando. Okay. Now you kids are probably asking yourself, hey Matt, how can I get back on the right track? How can I get going? Well, I'm here to tell you that I've got a solution, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in the back and I'm gonna get my gear and I'm gonna move in with you, Parker. I'm taking my van, I'm gonna put it in your driveway, and we're gonna be buddies, we're gonna be pals, we're gonna be brothers, amigos, me and you, okay? I need my helmet. Bloody freaking dog, you guys. Hey, are you guys pumped up? You guys pumped up?
Yeah!
This is all the football team right here, right? Yeah. I'll tell you guys what, you guys are one ugly group. But that's okay. Because all we need you to do tonight is play the Skyhawks and beat the crap out of them, okay? So, here's you! Here's me! There's you! Okay, man. We'll clean that up a little bit later. So what we're gonna do right now is we're gonna get pumped up and we're gonna cheer. Yeah. Woo! Yeah.
Stephen Franson. Yeah. And then these beautiful, lovely ladies to my left. This is Alicia Shelley. Her name now is Crump. I like it. This is Kelly Reed Schwartz. I don't know who they married, but anyway. And then Shelly Carter was our second attendant. So we'll get started with our second attendants, and then we'll work to the king and queen, okay? for our second attendant for the 2019 high school year is Mr. Sean Williams. Assembly in the main gym. Go to the main gym.